and more or less seem to be absorbed into the fine art community. Do you think the artists currently are still looking for that to be embraced by the fine art community?
I think some are, like in New York especially. I think when you step out of from the New York scene, you kind of see sometimes an overall perspective, you know? When you're in New York, like in the early 80s, they were trying to get a bunch of like, you know, really good graffiti artists into together on the one roof and to do like grap shows. And what happened was that it didn't become successful because there were better graffiti seen on trains. It was just like, why have, you know, mediocre graffiti on like in a gallery when you can see gallery for free? I mean, I know the galleries are free too, but you could see better art on trains, you know, and walls around the city. And so it didn't really hit it off because they didn't know how to control graffiti. Graffiti was out of control. And that's what's so special about the art. It is out of control. You can't control it. So they couldn't control a group of people to do, you know, the best art because, you know, they did good art, but, you know, you saw something better outside in the street. So it was like the real free form of gallery on the street, you know. So I'd rather have my art seen on a street corner by 600,000 people, by people like you and me, then have my art being seen by a few snobby rich people and try to buy my canvas. I get more thrill out of people seeing it, you know. Just because you want it, your art to be seen doesn't mean you want to be accepted by society. It's just say, look, take notice, you know, this is who I am, this is what I'm doing, and I'm not really looking to get accepted, you know.
It seems like that's a